time to talk provincial politics and everything going on in BC right now. And we're going to join Liza Yuzda right now from News 1130. Have you caught your breath from the election yet?
Sort of. Sure.
Yeah. It's been a little quiet for Premier John Horgan this week. Tell us what he's up to and as we look at the new cabinet.
I thought we might actually hear from him again this week. We heard from him the day right after the election on Sunday morning. He spoke. But hearing from his people, he's not going to speak this week, potentially next week. What he's really working on is trying to figure out his next cabinet. There's seven ministers that didn't run again. Carol James, who you guys are having on later, is the key of them. You know, she was really his anchor. But there's seven that he needs to fill that are experienced ministers who know how things run. So he's going to have some work to fill those. But of course, finance minister is the key one that Carol James is leaving. And Selena Robinson is one of the people that they're considering as, you know, one of the front runners for that. She was in housing. So, you know, there'll be some interesting moves around. I'm curious to see what he's going to do with education. Rob Fleming was, in my estimation, pretty quiet on that front when he probably could have been out front a bit more before the last election. So curious to see if he gets to stay. But there'll be a lot of shaking and moving going on before we get to see that final cabinet after the final count.
And outgoing BC Liberal leader Andrew Wilkinson still kind of hanging on to the post right now.
Oh, it's really interesting. I was talking to people that I know after he stepped down, but isn't stepping down until there's a new leader. What I'd heard before he made that speech was that they wanted to have a placeholder leader that, you know, I'd heard a few names tossed around of who that was going to be. Then when caucus returned and or met this week, to have an interim leader and then have a leadership race maybe a year down the road when they could, you know, get themselves together. But then Wilkinson came out and said, I'm stepping down, but I'm not stepping down. And I would like there to be a leadership race as soon as possible. There's obviously some really interesting things going on in the back room there. One of the MLAs put out a tweet saying that we need an interim leader, but then pulled it down because obviously that contradicted what Andrew Wilkinson said. So there'll be a lot of machinations going on in the background there. Curious to see how it'll all play out. And of course, then they're going to be looking for a new leader. And some of the people that hearing that they're looking at, of course, Diane Watts, who ran last time, that she'll run again. Jazz Johal, who is very front and center all the time, who lost his seat in Richmond, Queensborough, but hearing that he might be a possibility. Todd Stone, who was transportation minister when they were in power, from Kamloops, hearing that he could run again. And an interesting one, James Moore, federal conservative, right, that he might be someone who could appease the conservative side of the party, you know, the Lori Throness side of the party, but still, you know, keep them in the running. So we'll see where it all ends up. It's going to be fun.
All right, let's switch gears a little bit and talk locally about the coronavirus. Surrey getting serious about COVID-19.
It's really frightening. You know, they have 75% of the new cases and are active cases in the province. They've had 50% of the cases overall during this pandemic. So I spoke with the Surrey Board of Trade yesterday. I was actually just calling to say, hey, you know, what are you hearing from your people? Is this affecting their business? And they said they're Anita Huberman, their CEO, telling me that they've started this campaign working with the South Asian community, business community, called Get Serious, as you said, trying to point out to people that, you know, if we want to have businesses running as they are and not have them decimated when they're barely back on their feet, people need to stop having these events and gatherings. We need to stop the spread. So, you know, we'll see if that works. But she had said to me that the head of Fraser Health, Dr. Lee, had reached out and said, you know, we need some help getting this message out because we're still seeing the transmission spreading wildly.
All right, Liza. And as we wrap, the BCTF still has concerns about safety in the classroom.
They do. They're trying to get some direction. And it's really challenging because we're in this placeholder government that they're not getting the direction they need, or then the superintendents, more importantly, aren't getting the direction they need in the districts about where to spend this money that was put out there for pandemic, you know, precautions. And one of the key things they want to see happen is teachers being hired, but they're saying that there's no oversight of how this money is being spent. So we'll see how that happens. I asked Premier John Horgan that, and he said he hasn't been briefed yet, and he will let us know once he has been briefed again now that the election's over.
All right, Liza, we appreciate your time as always. Thank you.
Thank you, Thor.
All right, have a great rest of the week. That's News 1130's Liza Yuzda. And speaking of politics,